You may have heard that Bittensor is enabling top-tier products and services that surpass competitors with ease. But how is it doing this, and what is Bittensor? You can think of Bittensor as a constantly growing series of global athletic competitions. In global tournaments, competitors from all over the world compete against each other to determine who is the best at every sport. Bittensor takes this concept of worldwide competitions and expands it to not just sports, but anything. In particular, anything of value. For instance, on Bittensor, there is a weather prediction competition. We gather weather forecasters from all over the world, have them make predictions, and whoever's predictions come true most often is crowned the best weather forecaster in the world. There's another competition to detect fake AI-generated videos. We gather all the best AI detectors in the world and have them compete to find out who is best. There's another competition to provide VPN nodes. There's another competition to generate 3D video game assets. There's another for AI cancer detecting CT scan technology. There's competitions for advertising, for training artificial intelligence, even YouTube video creation. With Bittensor, we can create any type of online global competition that we can dream up. Each of these competitions determines who is the best in the world at producing something of value. Now, in a regular global sports competition, winners are rewarded with a medal. They might get sponsorships or brand deals. In Bittensor, competitors are called miners, and they are paid based on their performance. Thousands of people, including myself, are making a full-time living by producing value in these competitions. The rewards attract talent from everywhere on Earth, often paying more than one could hope to expect from their day job. So due to these financial incentives, the quality of the talent working in Bittensor competitions is second to none. But the real magic with Bittensor is that not only do these competitions find and reward the best workers in the world, it allows anyone in the world to purchase what those workers, the best in the world, what they produce. So we can actually access the best weather predictions in the world, the best advertising, the best data storage, the best anything. But how do we actually figure out who did the best work when it's not clear at all who produces the best advertising, or the best YouTube explainer videos, or the best weather forecasts, or the best AI agent algorithms? Each of these competitions is encapsulated in what's called a Bittensor subnet. Just like any sports tournament, if competitors don't follow the rules, they're disqualified. So each subnet has its own rules on what competitors must do in order to win that top spot. These rules are both to make sure that the playing field is fair, but also to make sure that whatever the competitors are producing is valuable. So for example, in our weather forecasting subnet example, the rules might be something like, competitors cannot change their prediction after it's locked in, and they can't copy their competitors' predictions. And then we just wait to find out how accurate the predictions are by comparing them against reality a few hours or days later. So there's a global competition to get the most accurate weather forecasts. And now that we have those forecasts, anyone can purchase those ultra-high quality forecasts. Now the rules are very different between subnets. The rules for an advertising subnet might reward advertisers who can drive the most traffic to a website. Or maybe they're rewarded directly for sales by competing against each other for the lowest advertising costs. For an AI training subnet, the rules might reward competitors that are able to train AIs the cheapest and quickest. Now let's look at the principles behind Bittensor. Bittensor is permissionless. It allows anyone to participate and interact with it without needing permission or authorization from a central authority. So that means permissionless work, enabling talent from anywhere in the world to sell their work. Also permissionless access, enabling anyone to purchase access to the commodities Bittensor competitions produce. And also permissionless ownership, enabling anyone to purchase ownership of these commodities or create new competitions to create new top quality commodities. So anyone can work, access, or start a subnet on BitTensor today immediately. There are no gatekeepers. None. BitTensor is also decentralized, making censorship difficult or impossible. BitTensor is also open source, so BitTensor advancements are public, allowing for maximum transparency, security, flexibility, and accelerating at a truly incredible pace. Put together, these attributes create a truly free market. A free market that is resistant to monopolies thanks to being permissionless, decentralized, and open source. It's also an extremely powerful market, as it permissionlessly allows anyone to work, and permissionlessly allows anyone to purchase access to the best talent in the world thanks to its competitive nature. So you might say that BitTensor is a foundational layer that enables global free trade, actual free trade. Remember, it's permissionless. Anyone can get started today. There are no gatekeepers, no sign-up forms, nothing. You require no permission to get started. You can literally start right after this video, limited only by yourself. So when we ask the question, how is BitTensor beating traditional businesses with ease? How is it providing the cheapest reliable storage, or the best weather predictions, or the most accurate AI detection, or the cheapest AI training runs? The answer is that BitTensor relies on open competition to identify the best providers of these services in the entire world. It compensates those providers and then allows customers to purchase those services that have been vetted as the best in the world. So a traditional company cannot sustainably beat a BitTensor subnet. No moats can protect a traditional business when literally anyone on Earth, a genius in a basement in Vietnam, a lab in Switzerland, or a startup in Nairobi, anyone can plug in as a competitor, and then any customer can purchase their work with the confidence of knowing that it's the best on Earth. A traditional business might be limited to the talent available within Silicon Valley, whereas BitTensor is completely global and has access to the entire world's talent pool. The open global competition that powers BitTensor is why BitTensor subnets don't just compete with traditional companies, they embarrass them. Often beating a traditional business on price or quality, and sometimes both. Now I bet you have many questions. There is a playlist in the description if you're interested in learning more about BitTensor.